Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 1 through 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 9, 1969, in Columbus, Ohio.
Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 4, Transcendental Knowledge. 1. The Blessed Lord said, I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivasvan, and Vivasvan instructed it to Manu, the father of mankind, and Manu in turn instructed it to Ikshvaku. Purport. Herein we find the history of the Bhagavad Gita traced from a remote time when it was delivered to the kings of all planets. The royal order is especially dedicated to the protection of the inhabitants, and as such, its members should also understand the science of the Bhagavad Gita in order to rule the citizens and protect them from the onslaught of material bondage to lust. Human life is meant for cultivation of spiritual knowledge, an eternal relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the executive heads of all states and all planets are obliged to impart this lesson to the citizens by education, culture, and devotion. In other words...
So, in this verse, the exact Sanskrit word is Imam Vivasati Yugam Prakt Proktvan Amabhyam Vivasan Manavi Praha Manu Ikhakavi Bravi Evang Parampara Praktam Imam Rajad Sayo Vidhu Sakali Neha Yuga Nasta Parantava. So, this Bhagavad Gita, science of Bhagavad Gita, is not a new presentation. Just from this verse you can understand that it was instructed to the sun god. Sun god, apart from what is the duration of age of sun god, but from the Manu, because the next statement is Vivasan Manave Prah. Vivasan, the sun god's name is Vivasan. Just like your the chief executive head is called the president. Similarly, there is a chief executive head also in the sun planet, president. And the present president's name is, just like your present president's name is Mr. Nixon. Similarly, the present predominating deity in the sun planet is known as Vivasan. So everything is in detail. This is called Vedic literature. Vedic literature is not concerned only with this planet. Vedic literature deals with all the universal planets. Just see, here is the statement. Krishna says that in the beginning I explained the science of Bhagavad Gita to the present predominating deity of sun planet whose name is Vivasa. Do you think that Krishna is playing joke or speaking something like that he said to Vivasa, the present presiding deity? No, that is not possible. Actually, he has spoken. And Krishna, one others may think of Krishna, Abhijananti Manga Murha. Rascals and fools may think of Krishna as ordinary man. But in India, the great acharyas, just like Shankaracharya, Ramanujacharya, Madhyacharya, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, practically, these acharyas are guiding the whole destiny of the Hindu world. They have all accepted Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God. So, whatever Krishna is speaking, that is right. Now, you can understand that if Krishna spoke to the sun god, and the sun god spoke to his son Manu, then how old is the science of Bhagavad Gita? Apart from sun god's duration of age, if you simply take the present age, Vaivasvata Mano, the age of Vaivasvata Mano is 71 multiplied by 4,300,000 years multiplied by 71. It's a very long duration of life. Now, at the present moment, the Vivasa, the Vaivasvata Manos is half finished. That means the number, the numerical strength, 4,300,000 years into 71, divided by 2, so long years Bhagavad Gita was spoken. So Bhagavad Gita is not a new thing, it's a new adventure. And the person who spoke Bhagavad Gita to the sun god, does it mean that he left something to be commented by some this mundane man to understand the meaning of the Bhagavad Gita? Such a great personality, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he told something which is to be understood by the interpretation of a mundane scholar. Do you think it is reasonable? No. Whatever he spoke, that is all that. And that is clear. There is no question of interpreting in a different way. Just like here, the Blessed Lord said, I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivasa. What is difficulty there? Is there any word which you cannot understand? Is anyone here who cannot understand these lines? It is clear. The Blessed Lord said, I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivasa. Everyone can understand that Krishna instructed this science of Bhagavad Gita or the yoga of Bhagavad Gita to the sun god whose name is Vivasa. It is clear. How you can interpret? Now the thing is, unless I think of Krishna, that he is an ordinary man, how he could say to the sun god, Vivasa, then the interpretation is required. But that sort of thinking is not bona fide. Because if you want to study Bhagavad Gita, you have to take the words of Bhagavad Gita. The Blessed Lord, He is Lord, He can say. The Lord is not like ordinary man. Because we cannot say to the sun god, therefore Krishna cannot say. That is our foolishness. Why should we calculate Krishna's activity with my activity? Therefore all the commentary who think Krishna as ordinary man, they are none and void. Such commentary should not be accepted. We have explained in our introduction that all the commentaries in the market, they are simply presentation of the particular commentator's personal view. That is not Bhagavad Gita. If you want to understand Bhagavad Gita, then you should understand as they are said. You don't interpret in your own way. Now, because there should be some doubt of the ordinary man that how Krishna could say to the sun god, that is explained in the next verse. Because Arjuna was taking instruction from Krishna. He knew Krishna, what he is. Otherwise he would not have accepted him as a spiritual master. But because others should doubt, this is fictitious, that Krishna said to the sun god, how it is possible? So, in fine, Arjuna said, the sun god Vibhasan is senior by birth to you. How am I to understand that in the beginning you instructed the sun to him? Krishna is taking our position. Hey, Arjuna. Persons who are thinking of Krishna as ordinary person. So Arjuna is trying to clear that point that Krishna is not ordinary person. He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore he has put this question, that the sun god Vibhasan is senior by birth to you. Sun god Vibhasan, the sun planet, father of Manu. Manu's age he cannot calculate, about 40 millions of years ago Manu was born, and his father, we do not know what is his age. So how it is possible, if Krishna is ordinary man, he spoke to him. That is being clear. So what he answered? The Blessed Lord said, many, many births, both you and I have passed. I can remember all of them, but you cannot. That is the difference between God and man. That is the difference between God and man. We cannot remember. Even we cannot remember what I did at this time, yesterday. That is our forgetfulness, is our nature. To commit mistake, to forget, to be illusion, to be cheated, in perfection of senses, these are our qualifications. Every one of us, anyone who is in this material world, they are subjected to these defects. He is sure to commit mistake, to aid his human. He is subjected to be illusive. And he has a cheating propensity. That's like a mundane scholar. I do not wish to name. A mundane scholar, he admits his introduction that it is very difficult to interpret Bhagavad Gita in one's own way. It is so tightly fitted. Actually it is so. Unless you contradict yourself, you cannot interpret Bhagavad Gita according to your own way. So, Arjuna is clearing that, and Krishna is saying, the difference is that I take, I appear, as you'll find later on, Krishna says, yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bharata tadatmanam sujama. Whenever there is discrepancies in the procedure of religious function, and there is predominance of irreligiosity, at that time God or God's representative comes to this world to make things nicely. So Krishna appears. Krishna appears and we also appear. But our appearance and Krishna's appearance is different. We have accepted this body. We have appeared in this world forced by our karma, according to our past deeds. Just that we are sitting, every one of us have different features of body. Why? According to different karma. The body is made according to karma. That is the explanation of difference. So we cannot know. And we can understand that your mentality, my mentality is different. You act in different way, I act in different way, that is the way. Every one of us. Therefore, we are forced to accept a certain type of body according to our own karma. But Krishna does not. We change our body. Let's try to understand. This forgetfulness means change of body. Just like we had some certain type of body in our previous life, but we do not know, forgotten. Because I have changed the body, therefore I have forgotten. What to speak of my last birth? In your childhood, when you are, say, 3 or 4 years old, you did so many things. But do you remember them? No. Because you have changed the body. That body is gone. Therefore you have forgotten. Forgetfulness means change of body. You are changing body every second, every minute. Therefore you are forgetting. And Krishna does not forget, that means he does not change body. This is pure understanding of Krishna. Krishna says that many, many births both you and I have passed. I can remember all of them. Many, many. Thousands and thousands of times Krishna appeared on this world. But he remembers everything. And I cannot remember about my childhood. So how can I become one with Krishna? This Mayavadi philosophers, they are declaring that I am God. How you can, what is your qualification that you become God? God is not so cheap thing. People have technique that everyone can become God. Everyone of us God. This is another illusion, another Maya, because we do not know what is God. Here is God. He says, many, many millions of years ago I spoke to Son God. I remembered. This is God. Simple truth. This is the proof that he is God. Read the explanation further in the Brahma Samhita. Read it.
In the Brahma Samhita, we have information of many, many incarnations of the Lord. It is stated there, I worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Govinda, Krishna, who is the original person, absolute, infallible, without beginning, although expanded into unlimited forms, still the same, original, the oldest, and the person always appearing as a fresh youth.
The exact verse in Sanskrit word is, Advaitayachyuta anadi anantarupam adyam purana purusam navajauvanancha vedesu dullabhadur lavayatva bhaktau govindam adi purusam tamaham bhajami. Advaita. Advaita means Krishna expands himself. Krishna can expand himself. That is God. Just like I am sitting here, you are sitting here. Suppose you are wanted by some relative at home. But if somebody inquires that Mr. Satansat is at home, they reply, no, he is not at home. But Krishna is not like that. Krishna Goloka Yoga Nibasati Akila Atma Bhuta. He is present everywhere. It is not that because Krishna was speaking with Arjuna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, therefore he was not in the Goloka or Vaikuntha. Not only Goloka, Vaikuntha, everywhere he is found in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is here also. Now, Ishara Sarvabhutana Middeshi Arjuna Tishtati. Krishna is everyone's heart. In your heart there is Krishna. In my heart there is Krishna, everyone. So Krishna is not like that. Therefore, Advaita, Achyuta, Anadi, Anantarupa. Ananta means unlimited. Yeah. But one, Advaita, there is no difference. That's like the electricity power. I give you a crude example. Yeah. Unlimited. Factories are running in electricity. Different types of work is being utilized by electric energy, but the electricity is one. Similarly, God is one, but He can expand. That is His potency. Prasa sakti vividhai vasyate. In the Bhagavad Gita, I will understand in the 13th chapter that Krishna says, Khetra-gancha-māṅa-viddhi sarva-cetre-su-bhārat. The living entity, I am living entity, you are living entity, every one of us. I am living in this body, you are living in this body. Yeah, we have got different bodies. So Krishna says that the living entity is the proprietor or the knower of the particular body. But He says again, Khetra-gancha-pi māṅa-viddhi. I am also knower of this particular body. Sarva-cetri-su-bhārata. In every body. Annāntarastham paramāna-cātram. He is in every body, in every atom. That is it. Now, I am living in my body. If there is pain here, I can understand here is a pain. But if there is some pain in your body, I cannot understand. Therefore, I am different from you. But Krishna can understand what is pain and pleasure in my body and what is pain and pleasure in your body and everyone's body. That is Krishna. Sarva-cetreshu. That is God. Not that simply by saying I am God. I am the same God. And how you can God? Can you tell what I am thinking? Can you tell what He is thinking? No? Then how, what kind of God you are? Don't accept that cheap God. These are the symptoms of God. Advaita yachyati anadi ananta rupa. He is an ananta. Unlimited. There are unlimited living entities. In the Vedas it is stated, nitya nityanang chetana chetanana. They are an unlimited living entities. Unlimited eternal. But there is one supreme eternal, supreme entity. What is the difference between this? The unlimited number, a plural number, and one singular number. That is also answer. Ekahi bahunam vidadhati kama. That singular number one entity is supplying the all the necessities of all the plural number entities. We are all plural number entities. The living entities, we are plural number. Nitya nityanam. This nityanam is plural number. What is it? Exactly. And He is nitya, He is one, similar number. Eka bahunam vidadati kama. That one is supplying the necessities of all. Don't you see how God is supplying all the necessities of birds, beasts and everyone? How is us? We don't acknowledge. Because we are civilized, we do not acknowledge. The birds, beasts also do not acknowledge. But because they are birds and beasts, so you are just becoming like birds and beasts, denying the existence of God, denying the authority of God. We are taking advantage. Vidadhati kama. If Krishna does not supply you this light, sunlight, in dark, but He does not charge anything. But because you are human being, you should try to repay. Oh, Krishna is giving us so much facilities. Let me render some service unto Him. This is Krishna consciousness. This is to acknowledge, O God, you are so kind. You are giving us so many things. So I have collected this fruit. It is your fruit. I know. Still, please accept. This is finished, your business. You are a great devotee. You are a great Krishna conscious personality. And Krishna says, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Jomi Bhaktya Prajacchati. Krishna does not want you from you. Very nice thing. Krishna is complete in himself. He can produce many, many nice things. He is not begging from you, but still he is expecting something from you. Because he is supplying so many things to you. Is it not? Suppose if you have got a friend, you always give him. Don't you expect something? I give so many things to my friend. He does not offer me anything. Don't you feel out of love? Father, mother, they do so many things for the children. If the children do not do anything for the father and mother, are they not happy? Are they happy? No. They are not. My children is all hungry. Although he does not work, Krishna is full in himself. But if we supply something to Krishna, Krishna's goods, to be supplied to Krishna. The fruit is not produced by you. Krishna says, Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam Jomi Bhaktya Prajacchati. Anyone who offers me a little fruit, a little water, and little leaf, oh, I accept. Tadaham Asnami Bhaktya Upuritam. Because he has brought with devotional love, I accept. If Krishna accepts your offering, then your life becomes sublime. That is Krishna consciousness. Simply you should have to acknowledge you are getting so many facilities of Krishna. He is sitting in your heart. He is supplying you all necessities. He is giving you sunlight. He is giving you moonlight. He is giving you rainy, seasonal rains, fruits, flowers, rains. And you are so ungrateful that you do not acknowledge. In your Christian Bible also, it is said, you go to church, O God, give us our daily bread. That's all right. Krishna is supplying bread. Otherwise, where from you are getting bread? You cannot manufacture bread in the factory or wheat or rice. You can manufacture some iron tools, that's all, not eatable. But you cannot manufacture nice grains. That is not possible. It is supplied by Krishna. Eka bhavanam vidadati kam. So try to understand in this way. Krishna consciousness, God consciousness. Then your dormant relationship with God and Krishna will be revived. Sita-dhatmanam arjanam. Lord Chaitanya says, by revival of Krishna consciousness, means the dirty things accumulated on our heart will be dissipated immediately. Then we shall see, this is my position. I am Krishna's and Krishna is mine. So, although Krishna is present everywhere, as it is stated here, Advaita Achyuta Anadi Ananta Rupam Adyang Purana Purusham. Adyang means the original personality. Krishna is the original father. You find in the Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Joni Shukantya Sambhavanti Murtayaja. In every species of life, all types of forms of life, then mother is this material nature, and I am the seed-giving father. The father is the seed-giving agent and mother gives the body. So this material nature is our mother. According to Vedic conception, the material nature, mother is worshipped. There are seven kinds of mother. Not one mother. आदो माता गुरु पत्नी ब्राह्मणी राजपत्नी का धेनु धात्री तथा पृथ्वी सप्तई ते मातर स्मिता आदो माता रियल माता सब हो वहते तुम बार आदो माता गुरु पत्नी दी वाइफ ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर आदो माता गुरु पत्नी ब्राह्मणी ब्राह्मणी दी वाइफ ऑफ ए ब्राह्मी लर्न स्कॉलर आदो माता गुरु पत्नी वाई लर्न स्कॉलर ही ऑल्सो गुरु बिकॉज फ्रॉम लर्न स्कॉलर यू लर्न सो मेनी थिंग्स एंड गुरु टीचर्स हर समथिंग देयरफॉर हिज फादर एंड हिज वाइफ हिज मदर आदो माता गुरु पत्नी ब्राह्मणी राजपत्नी का राजपत्नी मीन्स अ क्वीन And now there is no king and queen, but formerly there was king and queen. The queen is also mother, because king is father, he is giving protection to the citizen. Sadhu mata guru patni brahmani rajaputti ka dhenu, cow. Cow is our mother. Why? You supplying milk, you are drinking milk. Yeah. So, you are killing cow, so that's not good. Killing mother. आदो माता गुरु पत्नी ब्राह्मणी राजपत्नी का धेनु धात्री तथा पृथ्वी पृथ्वी दैट मेटीरियल नेचर इज ऑल्सो मदर बिकॉज दैट मेटीरियल नेचर हैज ऑफ दिस बॉडी सो इफ यू स्टडी वैदिक लिटरेचर वेरी नाइसली एंड इफ यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड देन योर लाइफ विल बी सब्लाइम सो दिस कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस मोमेंट इज Trying to give you all the authoritative information from Vedic literature. They are not manufacturing anything. They are not empiric philosophers presenting something mental concoction. No. Therefore, this Bhagavad Gita you have presented, Bhagavad Gita as it is. This is our business. Just like a post peon's business is to deliver the envelope as it is. And if there is good news, it is for you. If it is bad news, it is for you. But the peon's business is to deliver as it is. Similarly, our business is to present Krishna's message as it is. Then he becomes spiritual master. Spiritual master does not become grown just like tree. No. It is carrying the message from higher authorities, as it is stated. I told this message, Krishna says, to Bhimasa, the sun god. He told to his son, Manu. Manu told to his son, Ikhaku. In this way, this is coming down. Now it is broken, therefore I am saying unto you, Arjuna. So there is no difficulty in administering this Vedic message to the world, provided we simply carry the same message as it was delivered by Krishna unto. That's not very easy. Anyone can do it. You simply try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is and distribute it. Krishna says this, that's all. You haven't got to comment or add anything, something. but to present, you can speak something, but the central point should not be missed. Then people will be benefited. Then people will be benefited. They will receive the message as it is. And this is transcendental message. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, हमार अज्ञा गुरु हैया तारो सदोपदेश जारे देखो तारे कहो कृष्ण उपदेश लॉर्ड चैतन्य सेज दैट एवरी वन ऑफ यू बिकम द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर एवरी वन वाई वन टू एवरी वन ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट जॉब नो नो डिफिकल्ट जॉब चैतन्य मास्टर हमार अज्ञा जस्ट ट्राई टू कैरी आउट माई ऑर्डर दैट्स ऑल देन यू बिकम स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर And if you interpolate, if you put something nonsense, rubbish, to show your so-called rascal's education, then it is spoiled. Immediately spoiled. Immediately spoiled. And as if you present as it is, then it's pure. Tatvachishta payodatha avaishnava mukhat girna puto hari katha amritam hari katha. This message of Bhagavad Gita is hari katha. Hari means the supreme Lord. His word. Therefore it is word that do not try to hear this message of Hari or the Supreme Lord from rascal non-devotees. Do not try to hear. Why? Satpachishta payojatha. Just like milk is very nutritious food, but if a little milk is touched by the tongue of a serpent, the whole thing is spoiled. A serpent, a very thin tongue, if it touches the milk, the whole milk is spoiled. So, if we take such milk, milk is very nice. No, because it is touched by the serpent's lip, it should not be touched. Similarly, any transcendental message, any Vedic literature, unless it is presented by a self-realized devotee, it is poison. You simply misunderstand the whole thing and you do not get the benefit, rather you become a victim of misunderstanding.